it's a mixed ability class. Where you have people there of very high ability. And I've gone to grammar school in the old days. And people are of almost remedial standard. They come from varied background, not very far from the school. Again, the level of literacy varies. Some of them have a reading age of over 14, which is about how high you go. And some of them have reading ages of about 9. So as you can see, it's very mixed.
What don't you like about school?
I won't go to say I don't like it, but just sometimes you feel like working and sometimes you don't do no work.
So do you think, as Tony say, that school is a chore?
Yeah, I think he's right, yeah.
Do you think it must be done, though?
Yeah, I think it's got to be, well, you're supposed to work hard, but sometimes you don't work hard.
Somebody
if you've not got nothing when you leave school, then you're not going to get a good job.
What about you, Mary? What do you think? Do you like school?
Yes, yeah, it's alright. Sometimes it's boring, though.
When?
Like the teacher's just nagging and you just want to get out. You don't feel like working and the lesson seems to go on, just drags.
What do you mean by nagging?
Well, like they're going on about a subject, say maths, he's going on about algebra, you don't fancy working.
Is that because you don't like maths?
It's alright sometimes, some parts of it, but other parts are just boring.
Have you ever been tempted to stay away from school?
Yeah, sometimes.
Well, let's look again at Tony's poem. He says, school is a torch, must be done, or so we are told by our elders. What do your elders say about school? Do you find that they understand the subject that you're doing in school?
No. They take it as how they went to school and how they did subjects at school.
No, they think it's not strict enough. Mm-hmm. No.
Mm. What do they mean by not strict? Do they expect you to be caned?
Yeah, I think so. And then come to school in proper school uniform and everything, you know.
Has anyone here ever had the cane?
I went in primary school and I was different then. I burst out in tears.
What do you mean you were different then?
Well, I never used to play up so much. Muck about in class.
Now you're a good boy. How did you feel about it at the time? Did you feel ashamed?
Yeah, I knew when I was standing outside the office. And he said, come in, and there's enough story going around that he kept his cane in a drawer. And when I went saw him go to the drawer, burst out in tears. I just got a couple of whacks on the head.
Hmm. Did that change you, do you think? Did that make you think twice about being naughty?
Yeah.
Why do you think we need some sort of punishment in the school? Couldn't we just let everybody behave as they should be and have them untrust, if you like?
Yeah, but you need punishment to keep order. If you don't keep order, then you ain't going to get proper school running.
Right. Now, what I want you to write today is about a particular lesson that you've had. It could be a lesson which you like very much or a lesson that you dislike.
I give them as much stimulus as I can and follow it up from there, writing about home life, activities in the evenings, weekends. I try and encourage the children to write about their own experiences as much as possible.
Coming upstairs, my heart full flat. I just remembered my geography lesson. I can't stand that one teacher. She's so ugly and so vain. She can't stand our one poor class, and we can't stand her. Loudmouth is next door, shouting at my friend Huntley. Quite what a loudmouth, especially combined with our lesson. The detention on Monday, I don't intend to go. She get the head of you onto me. I don't care.
Right, so this is the type of thing I want you to write. I want you to write, for example, you hear the teacher call your name, you answer, then you go back to talking. I want you to write what you say when you're talking. What do you say to Jeanette, for example? Did you see the bionic man on television, something like that?
Some people are very imaginative, they have a lot of ideas, but when it comes to actually putting it down on paper, they find it difficult. I think this is true with a lot of people, not just with school children. I think they have the ideas flowing, but to actually stop and think and put it down probably takes away some of the ideas from them. I find that some children get careless as well when they're writing. It's as if they can't get it down quickly enough, and therefore spelling, punctuation and that sort of thing suffers.
I think you should have a paragraph there.
You've got it coming somewhere.